We'd like to welcome all of our viewers here. We are the King's Chapel Sibley. Happy to be once again coming to you in a real up-close personal way. We love you this afternoon because the Lord loves you. We are the church where everybody is somebody, and you belong here. The church in the heart of the city with the people of the city in its heart. If you're looking for a church home, looking for where the truth is being preached and being taught, King's Chapel Assembly Church is the church for you. Again, 703 East Jefferson Boulevard. For more information, you can go to kingschapelassembly.com. And thank you for sharing this word and sharing the opportunity for us to be able to come to you through electronic media. When you have the word, say with me, I have the word. All right, I want you to follow along silently as I read the word of the Lord aloud. Thank you for standing as you give reverence to God in his house this afternoon. In the book of St. Matthew, chapter 8, beginning at verse number 5, when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion beseeching him and saying, Lord, my servant lieth at home sick of the palsy, grievously tormented. And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. Drop down to verse number 13. And Jesus said unto the centurion, Go thy way. As thou hast believed, so be it done unto you. And his servant was healed in the selfsame hour. Verse number 14, and when Jesus was coming to Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother laid and sick of fever. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and ministered unto them. When the even was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spirits with his word and healed all that were sick, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. Let's look to the Lord this afternoon. Dear Lord, in the name of Jesus, we come before you once again in this holy place, realizing that you are Lord of Lords and King of Kings. We ask you that you look down upon our hearts right now, the very ground of our mind, and loosen the soil that this seed might be implanted within us. We pray that you would protect this seed and cover this seed and water this seed and let your word, the Logos, grow up in us, God. Let it be a rhema word to the heart that pricks us to a place of repentance and conviction and produces fruit, God. We pray right now for everyone in the house and those listening by the way of the airwaves that they might come to know how much you love and care for them. Let them come to faith today that they might repent of their sins, be baptized in the name of Jesus, and be filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. We ask that your blessings and your manna fall upon us fresh. We ask it right now as we look unto you. We ask it in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. Let's give him worship. Don't you love him this afternoon? Isn't he worthy today? Hallelujah. As you keep your Bibles open, I want you to look back to the text. Lord, we thank you. I want you to look at verse number 8 for your hearing this afternoon. The centurion tells Jesus, speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. For topic this afternoon, I want to speak to your hearts on the subject. Say with me, the touch of prayer. The touch of prayer. When we look at this area of scripture here, and I wanted to bring this together, what the Lord was doing in these settings, whether it be the centurion or whether it be Peter's mother-in-law and the other individuals that he was casting out demons, we want you to know this afternoon that the God that we serve is such a loving God, such a compassionate God. When Jesus went about doing what he was doing of healing and delivering, he did everything on purpose, and he had a reason for everything that he did. It was a blessing to come and count, to be encountered with the Lord. And remember, Jesus was limited to being in one place at one time. And either you had to bring sick individuals to Jesus or Jesus had to go to those individuals. Amen? Amen. We find here as we look at this that the centurion understands about the word of power. Amen? The word of instruction. As a centurion, he says here in a spirit of humility, which, of course, he's speaking in truth. He says, I've got a servant that needs healing, and he's sick of the palsy, grievously, the Bible says in verse number 6, tormented. And understand that we live in a world where people are tormented today because of sin. When the Lord first made Adam and Eve, they were sinless, and they were without ailments. They were without physical infirmities and issues. You also did not have mental illness. They were whole. And the Lord gave them a promise and said, but the day you eat of the tree of the knowledge of the good and evil, that day you shall surely die. Before death, of course, there is sickness, and we have inherited fallen nature because of disobedience. Everyone born in the world is born with fallen nature. The enemy works in this playground of sickness. He works in this area of being able to bring chaos and confusion. He works in the arena of bringing hurt and pain. Understand, the devil is a destroyer. This is one reason why drugs are such a terrible thing. Remember, there's a spirit attached to everything. And where we get the Greek word pharmaka, where we get pharmacy, which means to cast a spell, the illusion of the enemy is that he tries to promise you pie in the sky and all these things of a euphoria to make you feel good, only to allow you to come down and to crash. He doesn't tell you about the brokenness and how your body is torn up. You won't find in commercials through those that sell alcohol when everybody's holding up their glass, they won't show you the issues where individuals are dying of cirrhosis of the liver. They won't tell you that on cigarette commercials where individuals' throats and esophagus is being eaten up. So there's a price to everything that we put in our body. We are being broken down and debilitated. And when you look even at the spiritual component here, and this is not to say that everyone that is sick has a devil, but we understand, of course, as we look back in Jesus' time, that individuals were possessed of the devil. Once you know that, it's not something that has gone away, but the devil is still alive and doing well, and this is why we need to be in connection with God. Amen. As we look at this, there is a heartfelt desire of the centurion to have his servant healed. Even though he outranks him, he still cares about him. Even though he is his boss, he still loves him. It's a beautiful thing when you can find compassion. We see here the request that he puts out. In verse number 7, Jesus saith unto him, I will come and heal him. In other words, I'm going to make him well. Let me say this. From time to time, we all need healing. from time to time, and I was down a little bit over a week ago, and thank God for those who are able to pitch in this ministry and help the ministry go forward. So we all get debilitated from time to time. We all have mind battles and issues that really bombard us. Most individuals don't ask to get sick. They don't ask to have things happen to them. But because of our human nature is frail, no matter what we try to do, we still find ourselves coming down with different illnesses and diseases. We find here, as we look at this, again, when it comes to the power of the spoken word, I want to emphasize this afternoon and this afternoon's preach word that you can touch God with your word of prayer. Amen? Something has got to move God and cause him to act. Amen? The God that we serve today, thank God that he doesn't charge money for healings. Whenever you see something on TV or these TV preachers want to charge you for their healings, you need to keep your pocketbook close to your side, your money in your pocket, because God doesn't work off of, amen, financial gain. Amen. But we can touch him and we can move him, amen, by crying out to him. Notice here, there's no reservation in the mind of Jesus. Jesus, in other words, is getting ready to go to the centurion's house, but when you look at the fact of who the centurion is, and he himself makes the equation saying that he is unworthy, he says, but I do understand something about authority. Let me say this as a child of God, as a believer. If you have been filled with the power of the Holy Ghost, and again, this year we are building upon the promises of God, I want you to exercise here the power of being able to speak to God, the power of being able to touch God with your prayers. Jesus, the man says, brother, to Jesus, he says here, look, Lord, I can tell one man to go and he goes, another man to come and he comes. So I know what authority is all about. I have enough faith that all you got to do is speak the word and my servant shall be healed. Again, let's look at verse number 13 and let's read this verse together out loud. And Jesus said unto the centurion, you just go your way, right? As thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. And his servant was healed in the self same hour. No, Jesus didn't have to show up at the house for the centurion's servant to get healed. Amen. The man just had to believe it and speak it. Hallelujah. What I love about the Lord is he shows up here also at Peter's mother-in-law. Praise God. We find here that, she is sick and with a fever. He touched her by the hand and the fever immediately left her. In this case here, note, because Jesus is who he is, he doesn't have to pray anything. All he has to do is touch. Amen? I believe today, praise God. Amen. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I believe, amen, it doesn't take a long, drawn-out prayer for us to get the deliverance that we need. But when we speak to God in prayer, we need to speak with authority. Amen? How many still believe today that the blood still works? How many know today that the name is in the blood and the blood is in the name? In other words, there is authority in the name of Jesus. This is why we believe when you go down in water baptism in the name of the Lord Jesus, when that name is spoken over you, the Bible says to him, give all the prophets witness that whosoever believeth in him through his name shall receive remission of sins. How many know there's still something about that name? Hallelujah. Let's give him praise. Amen. Like anything that's good, once the Lord heals, amen, Peter's mother-in-law, we find here that they brought unto him many that were possessed, in verse number 16, with devils or demons. And he cast out the spirits with his word, cast them out. and healed this. Look at this. Healed all that were sick. Hallelujah. I believe the Lord told us when he said in the part of the Great Commission, he said that these signs shall follow them. Amen. In my name, they should lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Amen. How many have ever had to pray for yourself? Amen. When maybe your pastor wasn't around and maybe the mother of the church wasn't around. Maybe your natural mom or dad wasn't around and you found out it was just you in Jesus. Amen. And you had to get in contact with the Lord. Amen. And like anyone that's sick, amen, you don't have the energy and you don't have the drive. But I just want to encourage you that if you can just get the name of Jesus out of your mouth, hallelujah, amen. Sometimes you can get ready to go on your job or go into a situation where you, the Holy Ghost will let you know that you're getting ready to step into something where it's going to be demonically charged, amen. And the Holy Ghost will pre-warn you. The caution light will start to flash that before you walk into that circle, before you walk into that company, before you walk into that building, before you meet those individuals, you need to offer up a prayer ahead of time for what you're getting ready to face. Amen? Thank God that we serve a God of open access today that says, I'll give you what you need, amen, before you get there. All the healing today is wrapped up in the name of Jesus. Amen. Yes, God, we will need physical healing and we need emotional healing. There are times when things happen to us that feels like it just rips us to the core, amen. We heard some prayer requests this morning in Sunday school about some tragedies that took place to individuals that were gunned down, drive-by shootings. We heard other prayer requests of loved ones that lost their life because of drug addiction. And there is, if they're a parent, there's a child that's left behind, amen, that no longer has a mom or dad, and there are, no question to it, there are mental scars that are there, emotional scars where they need the healing touch of God. God says here, I didn't just make my creation. I didn't just plop them down on earth and say, fend for yourselves. But God said, I'll give him my church today the power and the authority to be able to touch me through prayer. Amen. Let's give him praise right now. Amen. What I love about the Lord, God knows even when we don't even feel like we're worthy. But again, this centurion says, Lord, I'm not worthy that you show up. But if you would just kindly speak the word, then I know the one I care about will be healed. Amen. And what I love about the Lord said here that I will heal him. And notice, it's not under condition. The Lord didn't say, I'll heal him if I show up. God said here, I found a man that had so much faith here. And we didn't read the text, but if you look at verse number 10, verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. Let's give him praise right now. I want you to know this afternoon that God is waiting for you to move his hand. And God is waiting today for you to speak out to him. And God is saying, I'm waiting for you to call upon me. And when you call on me, first God will be touched with the cares and the cries of his people that go out. Amen. God says, you're moving me with your words. And I'm reminded of Israel when Israel was down in Egypt land. And you all know the story. She was a slave, amen, to Pharaoh. And that's just like the enemy wants to keep people entrapped, being slaves, being told what to eat and where to go and when to sleep, having no rest, being tormented. But the Lord said, Israel, I hear you. You've been crying out for a Savior. And I'm going to send a man to you by the name of Moses. And Moses, you're going to feel like you're not adequate and you can't speak to the people. But nevertheless, Moses, I'm going to use you to tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Let's give them praise. Amen. Oh, I believe today, children of God, that we've got to be able to hold on to the name of Jesus, and we've got to speak that name in the atmosphere, praise God, over our children, over our loved ones, even over, amen, our workplaces, over our bosses today. People today that are possessed and that are ruled by the enemy, they don't know why they do what they do, but amen, they are controlled by a force that is greater than them. But today, we that are children of the light and not of the night, we know exactly, amen, where the devil is at and why he's doing what he's doing today. But if we can just get a hold, amen, of the power of prayer, amen, and allow the touch of prayer to move today, then I believe here this text will be fulfilled, where the Lord heals all manner of diseases. Let's give him praise in the house right now. Amen. Have you ever been plagued today with unforgiveness or a spirit of resentfulness, where something's happened to you and you said within your heart, I'm never going to forgive them what they did to me, and I'm always going to remember what they did. And first of all, in order for God to use us, we've got to be in the right mental position that the Lord could work through us, because many times we block not only our own blessings, but we block ourselves being a blessing to somebody else if our disposition and our attitude and spirit is not right. This is why we need to, first of all, pray for ourselves when we've been injured and when we've been forsaken and when we've been let down. Amen. See, it doesn't matter how you've been injured, but the number one person you need to pray for is yourself. Amen. You need to say, Lord, give me a clean spirit. Give me a pure heart, God. Don't let there be a speck of anything in my eye, God. And the terrible thing about unforgiveness, the Lord says, if you don't forgive others of their trespasses, then I won't forgive you of yours. And I don't know about you, saints, but there's nobody here walking on earth, amen, that's worth going to hell because of unforgiveness. Get it out of your heart. It doesn't matter how many times they offend you. Amen. Get it out of your heart and forgive them for Christ's sake. Amen. We need that healing today. There are families today where people are not speaking to one another and people have fallen out with one another. And we have a fragmented world today where, amen, people are going their separate ways. But today, I just want to talk to the people of God that believe in the power of the name of Jesus. Are there any people in the house today that knows there's power in that spoken name, Jesus? I just want to talk to the church that I pastor right now. Church, do you believe in the power of being able to touch, amen, through prayer today? It's the touch of prayer, amen. Again, it's the very words, amen, that come out of our mouth that moves, amen, the hand of God. And God says here, I'm willing to heal and I'm able to heal, but God says, I need a reason to stretch out, and I need a people that are willing to go and to bat for other people. In other words, I need somebody that's willing to be a pinch hitter today. I need some intercessory prayer warriors, amen. If we all were stuck in our own issues and our own qualms, then nobody else would be able to be healed today. But let's get in that place where we were intercede for somebody. Thank God for the centurion who interceded today for his servant. Thank God, amen, as Jesus walks in the house here. Amen, the others, they came and they brought their loved ones to Jesus. Amen, this means here, if the world is going to be healed today, amen, the church, we've got to be in our place, amen.
You cannot afford to lose it over here and be help to somebody else. But you've got to ask God to help you keep your mind stayed on Jesus. You've got to be aware of your surroundings. You got to know that the enemy goes about seeking whom he may devour. This is why I told you, even in pastors' families and bishops' families, amen, we already know we've got to pray because we've got a job on our hand. The enemy is coming out to destroy, amen, pastors' families and bishops' families because he wants the house of God to be a laughing stock. But today we've got to do those things that we know work for us. We got to do those things that we talked about in Sunday school. Go back to our foundation. Go back to our spiritual roots. Amen. Amen. It's not a time today to point fingers and say, I'd be a better person if it wasn't for you. No time out for the blame game. We need to take responsibility within our own selves and say, I'm going to be that strong man or woman that God is calling me to be. And when I've eaten my spiritual vitamins of the Word of God and I practice falling on my knees for myself, amen, then I then can be a better father. I then can be a better husband, amen. But I got to learn to get myself together. Come on, let's give them praise in the house right now. Lord, we thank you for you being a God that's touched, amen, with prayer today. Come on, let's give them praise in the house. Amen. We serve a God that is just a touch away. Amen. Reminded of the woman who had the issue of blood. You all know the story. She said, if I can just touch his garment, I ain't got to put my hand in his hand. If I can just touch his clothes, and I know I can be made whole. I wonder, do you have that much faith today? Do you have enough faith to say, amen, if I can just get to the house of God, let me get to holy land. Amen. If you've been broken down, amen, out there in the world, let's give them praise. If I can get to a holy place, if I can get to a holy people, if I can fall up under a mother of, amen, in the church who believes in the power of prayer, and I can allow them prayers to be put over me, amen. There's healing when you're in the right place. Amen. God said here, amen, I'm willing to move my hand, but it's up to you to create the atmosphere. Amen. Let's touch him today, saints. Let's touch God, amen, with a touch of prayer. God said, if you touch me with your words, then I'll show up. There's no reason for husbands and wives to fight like cats and dogs. Amen. There's no reason for children to run out of the house and not want to come home. If we can just say, let's pray together as a family. Yes, I got my issues. Let's own up to it, and you got your issues, but let's pray together as a family, and let's allow the mercies of God to fall on us. Let's ask God to help us get healing in the house. Then I believe today, then we don't have to go down to the carnal court and divide up things, and we don't have to, amen, get on the phone or Facebook and rail on somebody else, because we'll have healing in our house. Amen. Don't you want it today? God said here, I'm willing to move, but you got to be willing to approach me with faith today. Faith that says, number one, I believe that you are God. Amen. Number two, I believe that you're not just a God of power, but you're a God of emotion, which means here you're a God full of compassion. And if you're a God full of compassion, this means you're a God full of mercy. Amen. God's saying here, my people that are called by my name, if they could humble themselves and pray and seek my face, then I just believe in the power of prayer. I believe it's not hocus pocus, but I believe that when prayer goes out, God sends his anointing out. I believe when prayer goes out, I believe God knows how to dispatch his angels. Amen. How many still believe in angels today? God said here, no matter how thick the principality of demonology may be, God said, put some prayer on it. Amen. He took it, amen, in his body. Number three, when you go to him, go believing he is God, and he's a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. So Lord, today we're saying, since you bared in your body, he quoted from Isaiah here, himself took our infirmities and he bare our sicknesses. Thank you, God, that you took it in your body for us. With his stripes we are healed today. In other words, Lord, you got your back ripped up open because we needed your healing. And God said, I've got to heal some minds today. I've got to heal some emotional hurts today. God said, if I don't step in, there's going to be somebody that's going to take their life. But God said here, that demon doesn't have to take that life if my people would pray today. Not murmur, not complain and find fault, but pray today. The church that prays is a church of power. A church that doesn't pray is a church that has no power. But saints of God, as we move out this year in 2019, and as we stand on the promises of God, make sure you stand on prayer today. Amen. That as for me and my house, amen, we're going to open up our windows and call upon the Lord. There's not a law in Washington that they can make that can keep you from prayer. And no, they cannot keep prayer out of school. Amen. When you're riding on the bus, young people, you can pray and talk to the Lord. Amen. When you're at recess, eating your peanut butter and jelly sandwich, you can talk to the Lord in prayer. Amen. On your job in the break room, amen, you can close up the newspaper and give God a 10-minute prayer. And God said that prayer will make all the difference. If you want the atmosphere to change, then the Lord says you got to call on me. But the Lord says here, I need your permission. Amen. I've given you the right for me to move. So God is saying, I'm more than able to do it, but I need a reason to move. Amen. I need the current of power to move me. So the Lord said, I moved off of your words. So when my church is crying out for their children, God said, I understand what it is for loss, because I gave my only begotten son out on Calvary. The Lord said, I knew about loss before it happened to you, because before the world was made, already in the mind of God, God gave his son. It was already a done deal in God's mind that Jesus was already dead before he was born. Amen. So when the Lord shows up, God says, now I can identify with you. Amen. Because I gave, amen, my son, my only begotten son that I love. When I gave him to you, I gave him, amen, in your place. Amen. We were polluted, down, and broken. And God said, I got to allow somebody to make you whole. So the Lord said, I'm going to give you my son, and it's going to be through his blood. Amen. You'll get a spiritual blood transfusion. Amen. Let's give him praise in the house right now. That's why I said, when I see the blood, I'll pass over you. Why do you think that I'm getting ready to take my seat? How do you think you made it this far? God says, because not only have you prayed, but you had a grandmother that was praying for for you. Grandmother is dead, sleeping in her grave, but her prayers are still working on. Thank God for the prayer that keeps on moving down from one decade to the next decade. God said, I move through the power of prayer. Amen. Prayers don't have an expiration date. So when we call on God, I'm saying, Lord, bless my children and bless my children's children. Bless my lineage down through the years. And when I'm dead and in my grave, God said, I'm going to hear that prayer. Amen. And everyone out of your loins is going to be blessed today because it's your prayer and my prayer that moves God. Come on, saints, let's get out of our sadness and loneliness and depression and let's take it on up a little bit higher. I believe before we offer up prayer, we need to give God a praise, a radical praise, like he's already going to do it. Amen. Before the Lord shows up, you got to know God's going to help heal your finances. Yes, we need emotional healing when we got, amen, a kitchen table full of bills. God said those bills are weighing you down. But God said, I want to come in and show you that I'm Jehovah Jireh. Come on, somebody. Amen. God said, I got to bless you. Amen. But you got to call on me. So the Lord says here, come on and touch me if you please. Touch me with your prayer. How many are going to touch the Lord today? Amen. When you call out to the Lord, it's okay to say, Lord, I'm hurting right now. And I need you to touch me before I can touch you, God. Touch me where I'm confused, Lord. Touch me when I feel like running out, God. Touch me when I feel like fixing my own issues. Touch me, Lord. And God, if you got to sit on me, amen. Come on, Lord, just sit on me. Amen. Lord, sit on me heavy. Because, Lord, if you don't hold me, I'm going to make a wreck of my life. And the Lord said here, when I show up, amen, and my anointing comes in your life, then you're going to know that I'm God. I just want to encourage you, be still, amen, and know that he is God. But in your stillness, the Lord said, I'm a come to you, amen, not in a thunderstorm, not with a great big loud noise, but in a small quiet voice, the Lord said, I'm showing up. I believe the Holy Ghost will let you know if you can get to your still place. Amen. That everything is going to be all right. Amen. How many got that reservation down on the inside? See, the centurion knew, Lord, I'm not worthy for you to come in my house, but Lord, all you got to do is speak the word. And Jesus went his way, and the centurion went his way. And by the time he got home, his amen servant was healed. After you already done talk to the Lord, you got to know that the Lord has already fixed it. Amen. And when you get back to the issue, it's a done deal. The bill is paid. Amen. The mind is shored up. Amen. They didn't lose their life. Amen. There's been healing because of prayer. But you got to have peace in the between times. It's in the between times that you got to trust God. And the Lord said, on your way back, can you give me praise? He told Mary and Martha, take me to your dead place. But when the Lord got there, he just said, Lazarus, come forth. I believe through the power of prayer, you need to ask God, Lord, it looks dead right now. Speak some life to it right now. If you got a dead relationship, amen, praise God, ask the Lord to quicken it. Fell out with a son or a daughter, Lord, come on and quicken it. Amen. Got some resentment in your heart because you got burnt. Ask the Lord to quicken it. The Lord is saying, show me where your dead places are. Show me where is your sick area. We used to tell our little kids, is. You got an ouchie oochie. Show me where it is. Amen. And God said, if you're willing to open up and be real with me, amen, open up and show me where it hurts. Come on, church, open up and show you why you're confused. The Lord said, if you open up and let me touch you where it hurts, amen, when the Holy Ghost touched you, then you're going to know that you sure enough been touched by God, because God doesn't do anything half-heartedly. When the Lord heals, he makes you whole. When the Lord heals, you are delivered. When you've been delivered, amen, from alcohol, you've been sure enough delivered. When you've been delivered from crack, you've been sure enough delivered. When you've been delivered from sugar diabetes, you're sure enough been delivered. Come on, let's give them praise today. But you got to hold on by faith today. If God said it's for you, then don't forfeit it. Don't go back to it. Don't speak sickness back in your life. But let the Lord know that I'm healed all the way. I'm delivered all the way. There's complete power in the name of Jesus. Let's stand all over the house. Come on down, altar workers. So today it's to be in touch with prayer. It's the touch of prayer. Amen. So Lord, I'm going to cry out. Lord, I'm going to plead the blood. Lord, I'm going to cry out for my family. I'm not satisfied until they all get under the blood. I may feel discouraged along the way, but I can't stop praying. I can't stop coming to church. I can't stop taking God at his word. I can't stop believing. I got to have complete faith today. The Lord said, if you believe me and don't faint, if you believe me and don't doubt, he said, so be it unto you. Come on, somebody, as thou hast believed. The reason why there's not healing, because there is no faith. But if you can give faith as a grain of a mustard seed, the Lord said, I'll show you about spiritual leverage. God said, let me take that little bit of mustard seed faith, put it up underneath that mountain, and like a little jack is able to lift up a car, that little bit of faith is able to lift up that mountain. You never would have thought a speck of faith of a mustard seed could move a mountain. But how many believe God's word? God said, if you got that much faith, you can speak to your mountain and it shall be removed. So as we get ready to call, amen, amen, you down right now. At your seat, give them praise. Amen. Where you are, speak to your mountain. Speak to your bills. Speak to that loved one. Speak to the spirit that's controlling them, and let the enemy know this day, no more I'm giving it to God. No more worry. No more lying awake at night, but I'm giving it to God. I'm speaking my, come on somebody, I'm speaking my deliverance, because the Lord said I can speak it. So I'm speaking the name of Jesus. I'm speaking that name today. And every demon's got to give back at the name of Jesus. Let's stand all over the house. AV, you can roll it here if you need prayer today. Amen. Praise the Lord. You can come on down. We'll be happy to pray for you. No matter what you're going through in life, we're willing to anoint you. Amen. We're willing to lay hands on you right now. Amen. And there is healing in the house today. How many believe in healing? There's healing. We got enough people in here. Amen. For there to be healing in the house today. Come on, we're the praying mothers of the church. Where are the weeping mothers at? Amen. We're the prayer warriors today. Hallelujah. The Lord's a healer today. If you want to come down to this altar, if you want to receive prayer, if you want to kneel at the altar, if you want to go down in water baptism in the name of Jesus right now, this is your time. Amen. Won't you come? Won't you come? The Lord loves you today. The Lord loves you today. He said, you've been bearing this thing a long time, but now's the time. Now's the time. Won't you come?
Yes, he is.
Sometimes weapons form against you, but they'll never prosper. Remember, God is your shield.
He's waiting for your call.
He is waiting for your call, waiting to shield you from your foe.
And there's a place of rest and peace.
There's a place of rest and peace in the sanctuary.
And here's the good news.
Peace is waiting.
Peace is waiting.
Hallelujah.
In the sanctuary. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Peace is waiting.
Peace is waiting.
It's waiting for you.
In the sanctuary.
Come on and receive it right now.
I've got one more verse. Listen.
Sometimes your bills can stress you.
Can I get a witness in here?
But remember God's peace.
He's a peace giver.
He's a peace giver.
I bet you can relate to this.
Sometimes your money's running low and you're worried how you'll make it. But God will supply your.
Anybody know he'll supply your needs? He's waiting for your call.
He's waiting for your call. Waiting to shield you from your fall. And there's a place of rest and peace in the sanctuary.
Everybody lift your hands if you feel him moving in this place. I feel you moving.
I feel
in the sanctuary.
In the sanctuary.
Rest in you now.